sun. That's how I survived in these dirty rotten slums. These dirty rotten slums. These dirty rotten slums. God gave me his only begotten son. Hey, yo, no matter- Praise be Jesus Christ. How you doing, my brothers and sisters in Christ? Welcome to Sunday Readers with Charlie the Catholic. This Sunday, I'm taking you guys with me to church. Ain't that right, guys?
Yeah!
Come and join us and worship the one and true living God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. One God forever and ever. Got my father-in-law here with me. He comes with us to church every Sunday, right? Yes. Say hi to my viewers.
Hi, everybody. Good blessing.
And blessings.
All right, guys, welcome to my parish. This is St. Stephen's Parish. We're out here about to go for the 31st Sunday in Ordinary Time. And let's get into today's readings. A reading for the book of Deuteronomy.
You and your children and grandchildren must fear the Lord your God as long as you live. If you obey all his decrees and commands, you will enjoy a long life. Listen closely, Israel, and be careful to obey. Then all will go well with you, and you will have many children in the land flowing with milk and honey, just as the Lord, the God of your ancestors, promised you. Listen, O Israel, the Lord is our God, the Lord alone. And you must love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, and all your strength. And you must commit yourselves wholeheartedly to these commands that I am giving you today.
The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Today's responsorial song comes from Psalm 18.
The Lord is my rock, my fortress, and my deliverer. My God is my rock, in whom I take refuge, my shield and the horn of my salvation, my stronghold. I called to the Lord, who is worthy of praise, and I have been saved from my enemies. The cords of death entangled me, the torrents of destruction overwhelmed me. He is the God who avenges me, who subdues nations under me.
Going into today's second reason, we're going to go into the letter to the Hebrews. A reading from the letter to the Hebrews.
The former priests were many in number, because they were prevented by death from continuing in office. But he holds his priesthood permanently, because he continues forever. Consequently, he is able for all time to save those who draw near to God through him, since he always lives to make intercession for them. For it was fitting that we should have such a high priest, holy, blameless, unstained, separated from sinners, exalted above the heavens. He has no need, like those high priests, to offer sacrifices daily, first for his own sins and then for those of the people. He did this once for all, when he offered up himself. Indeed, the law appoints men in their weakness as high priests, but the word of the oath, which came later than the law, appoints a son who has been made perfect forever.
The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Now the gospel reading. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark. Glory to you, O Lord.
And one of the scribes came up and heard them disputing with one another, and seeing that he answered them well, asked him,
which commandment is the first of all?
The first is, hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. And you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these.
You are right, teacher. You have truly said that he is one and there is no other but he. And to love him with all the heart and with all the understanding and with all the strength, and to love one's neighbor as oneself is much more than all whole burnt offerings and sacrifices.
When Jesus saw that he answered wisely, he said to him,
you are not far from the kingdom of God.
And after that, no one dared to ask him any question.
The gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. You see that? Ten Commandments brought down to two. Love God first above all things. You got to love God even above me and above Papa. God comes first. See, God is the source of all gifts. You can't put the gift above the source of the gift. You understand? And then the second commandment, it's a two punch. You know what I'm saying? It says, love your neighbor as yourself. So you have to love yourself as you love your neighbor. You see that? You got to love yourself as you love your neighbor.
And also God in the middle.
All right, guys, so that's it. Today's going to be a brief show. I hope you like it. Go to charliethecatholic.com. Wear your faith. Share your faith. I appreciate everyone who likes and shares. And, yeah, let's go to church.
It just got more sunnier.
Yeah, that was God shining his light on us, huh? All right, love you guys. Bye. You want to say anything?
Wait, I want to say anything. Go to charliecatholic.com and also watch Charlie Catholic. Just, and also, I think you might need to ring that bell.
And then.
And that's it.
So how'd you girls like church, huh?
Good.
We found a new member over there, huh? My daughter Angelina. Say hi to my viewers, Angie.
Guess what? We got Dunkin' Donuts.
That's what happens when they're good in church, huh? When you're good and behave at church, you get Dunkin' Donuts. Hey, Dunkin' Donuts, you should sponsor Sunday Readers with Charlie the Catholic. If not, I might have to blur that out and blur out the Dunkin' Donuts and just say donuts. You know what I'm saying? Hope you guys enjoy church. Remember, love, that's the message. Love is the greatest commandment. And who you gotta love first? God. You must love God first with all your mind, all your strength, all your heart, all your soul, everything. God comes first. I'm gonna tell you girls a story. When I was a young little boy, what I wanted for Christmas was a drum set. I wanted it so bad, right? And guess what? Christmas came, we opened all our gifts, and I thought it was it, no more presents. My mom and dad gave me a key to a room they had locked, and they said, hey, Charlie, open it up. One more gift in there for you. I opened it up. It was a drum set in there. This is the first time in my life I've been so happy that I started to cry. I love that drum set. But guess what? I love the drum set, but I'm not gonna love the drum set more than my mom and dad who gave me the drum set, you know? You don't put the gift above the source of the gift. And all gifts come from God, so we cannot put what God gives us above God.
And I think, Bob, you still have the drum set.
I do still got the drum set. And also love. You know what? It might sound crazy, but like, I love you, right? You came from God. God gave you to me, right? I love God so much for that. Now, if I love you with just my strength, I can only love you so much. But if I love you through God, I can love you through God's strength and love you infinite. All right, girls?
Yes.
All right, say, tune in, smash the like button, share, subscribe, and go to charliethecatholic.com. Wear your faith, share your faith. Yeah, and also take off the mask. I mean, seriously, you guys don't need a mask in the car. What is this? Say bye, Mika. Say bye, suegro.
All right,
everybody. Bye. Tune in next week. Next week will be a procession. Next week's the second annual procession. It's a rosary for the conversion of the country. And that's going to be a special episode next week. Because I'm going to be involved with that, okay? I love you guys. Bye. All right, girls, you having fun? Got a lot of candy? How about you? You having fun? Got a lot of candy too?
No, he does not have any.
Where's
candy.
Your dinosaur? Arr.
Let's go.
Hey, listen, I wanted to throw something in here before I concluded with this week's episode. I'm gonna make it a teachable moment for my ladies, my young princesses, and my young prince. Listen, it's Halloween, right? And you're gonna hear a lot of people tell you, oh man, that's a bad holiday to celebrate, or this and that. But I'm gonna tell you the Catholic significance of it. You know why? Okay, let me tell you this. Hallowed. Remember when we say to Our Father, we say, hallowed be thy name? That means holy be your name. So hallowed means holy, right? And that's because tomorrow is a holy day of obligation. Tomorrow's All Saints Day.
or All Holy, Saints, Holy. So it's called All Hallows Day. And today, being the day before that, it's the Eve, All Hallows Eve. All Hallows Eve, Hallows Eve, Halloween. You get it? Halloween.
Bobby.
You got it?
Bobby.
Got it?
Bobby, I already,
got it.
Bobby, I already knew that before you brought that up, so it's more like my hat.
Oh man, she already knew that, so she knows it all. Just like all women, just like your mother, you know it all already. It's like, I'm just kidding. I'm gonna edit that out. Hopefully, my wife don't see that part. All right, guys. I just want to add that in. We're out here celebrating Hallows Eve. Hallows Eve, cause tomorrow's All Saints Day, and go to church. All right, it's the holy day of obligation, and may all you holy saints and angels and saints pray for us. The communion of saints, pray for us. All you angels and saints, pray for us. Saint Joseph, pray for us. Our Lady, pray for us. All right, guys, let's go across the street.
God gave me His only begotten Son.
Hey, yo, no matter what I'm in, He's my Lord, my friend, my Savior, who died for my sins. And truly we need Him. They brutally beat Him until He was bleeding. Until I would see Him, then I would believe in. He was born of a virgin to the thorns He was wearing, and I swore I was serving, but I slacked.